Good day. Today we are going to do chapter 4, which is the salient pole alternator and motor. Here we are going to consider the two reaction theory, where we have an interpole flux and a direct flux. The one is called the direct flux and the other one is called the quadrature axis. Now, to be able to develop a phasor diagram for this alternator, we need to know the power angle delta. And that can be determined by E angle delta is V angle 0 plus IA XQ 90 plus or minus phi. It's only necessary to use the angle and not the magnitude. So once we've got the angle, we can start to calculate the direct axis and the quadrature axis current. Now ID is equal to IA sine phi plus delta. IQ is IA cos phi plus or minus delta. Those are then the two components. IQ is always in phase with E, and ID is perpendicular to that. So now, if we want to develop the phasor diagram, we start off with the reference phasor V and the current at the power factor angle of lagging phi. Now, after we resolved IQ and ID, we can say that E is equal to V angle 0 plus IR angle phi, because it's always parallel to the current causing it. And then perpendicular to IDXD, ID, we get IDXD. That is the same angle as delta. And then perpendicular to that, we find that it is IQXSQ, and the angle is 90 plus delta. And the sum of all this gives us E. And then the developed power will be 3 VE over XD sine delta plus 3 V squared over 2 XD minus XQ divide by XD XQ sine 2 delta plus 3 I squared R. The developed torque is equal to the developed pi divided by 2 pi ns. Now, this part here, the first part, is called the power due to excitation, and the second part here is called the reluctance power. So if we want to determine the maximum load angle and the output power, we have to differentiate P developed by towards delta. So then we get 3 VE cos delta minus 3 V squared XD minus XQ, XQ times XD cos 2 delta. And then if you equate that to zero, we can find the value of delta. So therefore we can say the maximum value for delta is minus EXQ divided by 4V times XD minus XQ plus a half, the square root of a half plus EXQ over 4V XD minus XQ squared. Or we can say that it's K minus K1 over 8K2 plus square root of 8K1 over K8K2 squared plus 0.5, where K1 is EV over XD and K2 is V squared XD minus XQ over 2XD XQ. An example, a synchronous alternator has XD is 0.8 and XQ is 0.6 per unit. It is supplying full load At rated voltage and the power factor of 0.8 lagging, we have to compute the induced EMF and the developed power. So first of all, we need to find the load angle. That is, E is equal to V angle 0 plus IM XQ 90 minus 36.87. That gives us a value of 1.36 angle 17.13. We're not interested in the value 1.36. We just want the angle. So now we can say that ID is IA cos phi plus delta and IA sine phi plus delta. ID is then 0.809 per unit and IQ is 0.588 per unit. Now, E is equal to V plus ID XSD angle delta plus IQ XSQ 90 plus delta. That gives us 1.603 angle 17.3. Now, you will always see if this angle here is the same as that angle there, then you know that you've done the calculation correctly. Then we can find the developed power. Because we are working per unit, it is VE over XD sine plus V squared over 2 XD minus XQ divided by XD XQ sine 2 delta. Sticking the values in there, we get it 0.801 per unit. Now again, if we draw the phasor diagram, we start off with the reference voltage and the current lagging. Now we've got E, so that is in that direction. So perpendicular to E, we find ID, and in phase, we find IQ. Now we can say that ID XD will be that angle there, ID XD, and that will be IQ XQ. So that angle is delta, that angle is phi, that angle there is delta, and this angle is 90 plus delta. And then we have E. Now let's look at the phasor diagram for a leading power factor. There we have a leading current phi. This is our load angle delta. And then we break it up into IQ and ID. So IR is always in phase with the current causing it. So that angle then will be phi. Then ID XD will be parallel to E. So therefore that angle will be delta. And perpendicular to that ID XD we get IQ XQ. So therefore that angle is delta. And the whole angle is 90 plus delta. So that we can say that E angle delta is equal to V angle 0 plus IR angle phi plus ID XD angle delta plus IQ XQ angle 90 plus delta. Now if we consider a motor with a lagging power factor, E angle delta is V angle 0 minus IM XQ 90 plus or minus phi, so that we find ID is IM sine phi minus delta, IQ is IM sine phi minus delta. There you can see there's phi, and that angle A is delta. So that's why we have a difference between the two. Okay, so now we can say E angle delta is V angle 0 plus IR. Now, this angle here will be 180 minus phi plus IDXD is again 180 minus delta plus IQ is minus 90 minus delta. Okay, then we for a leading power factor. Again, leading power factor for an alternator was in that direction, so for a motor it's in the opposite direction. So there's the angle phi and our delta. So if we want to look ID is IM sine, this whole angle phi delta, phi plus delta, and IM cos phi plus delta. Now, if we add those phases together, we get E angle delta is V angle 0 plus IR angle 180 plus phi plus IDXD at an angle of minus delta and IQXQ minus 90 minus delta. So that must be minus delta. Okay, yeah, I've said do not memorize these phasor diagrams. Make sure you understand how they are constructed. And if you get this wrong, you will get zero for the question in a test or an exam. And this is usually worth about 20%. So make sure that you can do them. Do not memorize them. Like I say, understand them. Right, the next example. A 70 MVA 13.8 kilovolt 40 pole 50 hertz salient pole star connected alternator has armature resistance of 0.0125, reactance of the direct axis is 1.3 and XQ is 1.21. It's operating at full load at a power factor of 0.8 lagging. We must compute the developed power, the reluctance torque, and the voltage regulation. First of all, again, we calculate the full load current, and then we need to know what the load angle is, which is V plus IA XQ 90 minus phi. Because it's a lagging power factor. So that's 13.8 divided by square root 3 plus 2928.59 angle minus 36.87 times XQ, which is 1.21 angle 90. That gives us 15.69 degrees. So we only want the angle. ID is IA sine phi plus delta. You see we are looking at that angle there, which is the sum of delta and phi. Then we get ID is 232.5,27 amps, and IQ is 1780.38 amps. Now we can calculate the induced EMF, which is V plus IR angle 0 minus phi plus IDXD angle delta plus IQXQ angle 90 plus delta. If you add them all together, you will get 11878 kilovolt or volts at an angle of 15.55. There you can see it's basically the same as what we calculated in the beginning. Then the developed power is EV over XD sine delta plus V squared over 2 times xd minus xq over xd xq sine 2 delta. That gives us 18.613 kilowatt per phase, total of 55.839 kilowatt. Now, the reluctance torque is 60 times 3V squared over 2 times XD minus XQ divided by XD XQ sine 2 delta divided by 2 pi NS. That gives us 883.88 kilonewton per meter. Voltage regulation 11,878.3 minus 7,967.43 divided by that gives us 49.08%. Another example, an 80 kilowatt 550 volt 50 hertz 3-phase 10 pole synchronous motor draws rated current at a leading power factor of 0.95 with XD is 0.8 and XQ is 0.5 per unit. We must determine the maximum torque the machine can develop. Well, first of all, we have to draw the phasor diagram. A leading power factor is that way. And we have phi and delta. So E is V minus IMXQ, 90 plus delta, applied phi. That gives us 1.25 at an angle of 22.33. So ID is IM sine phi plus delta. There you can see again, it's the sum of those two, which is 0.6499. And cos of that angle is 0.7601. So therefore, if we sum all of them, we get E is 1 plus 0 plus 0.6499 times 0.8 angle 180 minus 22.3. 180. Plus 0.7601 times 0.5 angle minus 90 minus 22.3. That gives us 0.405 at an angle of 22.35. Then the developed power is EV over XD sine, which is due to excitation, and V squared over 2 times XD minus XQ over XD XQ sine 2 delta is the reluctance power. So now we can say that K1 is EV over XD, which works out to be 0.5064, and K2 is V squared over 2 XD minus XQ divided by XD XQ, and that gives us a value of 0.375. Now to determine the maximum load angle, it is minus K1 divided by 8K2 plus the square root of K1 over 8K2 squared plus 0.05. That gives us 0.55817, which gives us the load angle of 56.07. Now if we substitute it back in the formula, we get the maximum power is 0.5064 sine 56.07 plus 0.375 sine twice that angle gives us 0.7675 per unit. And therefore the maximum torque is 0.765 divided by 2 pi divided by 10, which gives us 12.216 times 10 to the minus 3 per unit. To get it to actual value, we can just multiply it by the rating of the machine. And this concludes chapter 4. Thank you.